So we are in the Semicha program in Siman Kuf Nun Tet, and we read the paragraph Hey, and we did two Biet Yosef, and we got in the Mishna Berurah until Mishna Berurah Kaf Hey, and that's where we're going to start right now. But first, I want to say over what's the subject matter that we're dealing with. So the subject matter is the vessel that we are using for the washing of the hands, and we are discussing the something that have a barrel in the underneath. So not a barrel, a barrel that have a tap underneath. Yeah. So it doesn't have to be like a big barrel; it can be like a gallon kind of. There is like big bottles like that that have like a tap underneath. So anything like that, because this is the way it is made. So even though you can open the tap and it will make literally a hole in the bottom of the vessel, but because this is the way that this vessel is made, so it doesn't cancel the fact that it is a vessel. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So we count it as a vessel, and you can use it to wash hands. And that's the Mishna Berurah Kafe Kli Sheyesh Lo Barza. A vessel that have a tap, I know much going tzapin. What is tzapin? Berez, tap. Oh, shalom aleichem. We're having a halacha class now.
Oh, great.
You're welcome to join us.
For a little bit, I was passing by, I was going to give you to pay for the sitter. But I don't want to interrupt.
Okay, so.
Don't try. Oh, I see.
Okay, yeah. So again, we are talking about a vessel that have a tap underneath, and we say you can use it for washing hands. Mashgurim handsup. What is handsup? Handsup is a barrel, a water barrel. Fine. Shesh le'etet milemata. So they had a kind of a barrel that had like a stick. Not instead of a tap, there's like a hole in the barrel. And they stuck a stick inside of the hole. And then when they, instead of opening the tap, when you don't have the means of a tap, so you just pull out the stick and then the water comes out, right?
Yeah.
You push this handle upwards, then the water comes out, and you have to put back the stick whenever you want the that it will count as washing of the hands, right? And that's what we do when we don't have a vessel, right? We have taps in the water system, and we open the tap every time, like open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close, yeah, six times, and that we count as washing the hands, but the effort when we don't have a vessel, right? So that's based on this halacha here.
But that's different when we, the way that we're doing it nowadays, because a barrel or a chug, you would fill it up and then you would raise it, right? So it would be have the power of your hand.
He's talking about like big barrels that are like standing.
Okay.
You don't. It's not something that you pick up. Like you place it somewhere, and that's
it gets filled.
Gets filled, whatever.
Okay.
And you use it when you need.
So the pump caused that from you turning the water.
Yeah, when you like taking out and putting back the stick, moving it around, whatever, so that what makes it, that it counts as your, like a koach gavra, like your strength that is moving the, bringing the water out. Okay. Ayin memagen Avraham, mimen asham kli zeh, al yedei nekev zeh, mutar litol ben derech barza, ben lemala, derech pi chavit. Okay, so again, we have two ways how to use this barrel. You can pick it up, so you can like literally pick it up and pull from the opening above, as we do with the small vessel. So you can do it also with the big vessel, but it has a hole underneath, so maybe it doesn't count as a vessel. The answer is it counts as a vessel, because this is the way that those vessels are made. It's not something that it was a complete vessel and then it got a hole. Then the hole makes it that it won't be a vessel anymore. But here we're talking about something that's the way it's made, and that's fine, right? So another possibility, if you don't have the way to pick it up because it's too heavy, whatever, so then you can just like or switch the tap, or like whatever it is, like whatever is the system of like taking the water out. So move it around, let the water flush on your hand, put it back with the other hand, and so on and so forth until you're done with your washing in the hands.
Is the reason because it has to be from your own motion, the water you use?
Yeah, it have to come from your strength. Okay, now Mishna Berurah. There you go. Okay, I read also Kaf Vav without saying that. I think I jumped the line maybe. Again, okay, so yeah, I jumped the line. So when you're doing this way of washing the hands, each of them, doesn't matter which of them, you have to make sure that every time you're pouring water on the hand, it will cover the hand, right? So if you have a tap that when you're opening it, so it goes, it like it drips like for a while until it like it started to flush, or maybe there's not like not enough of water pressure and it's just like small stream and it's not enough to cover the hand, so then it's a problem. Mm. Yeah, so that's a benefit that you have like a vessel that so you can fill it up and then you can pour in one flash and cover the whole hand, right? When you just opening the tap, if you don't have the right pressure of the water there, so then it might be a problem that it just like drops on the hand and it doesn't really do the job of washing the hands.
Just like only the first part is kohakara, like only.
Right, and it continues to drip, but it's not like you need to have a situation that with your movement, the flesh of the water covers the hand. So if you're talking about the tap and you don't have the right pressure there, so it won't happen.
It's like that lentil size hole, roughly. Like you have to have a nice size hole for right, it to right, right. Let the bottle of water right.
So we're not talking about the amount of water in the tube itself, though. Which is have an amount of water in the tube itself that's inside already. So when you open, the pressure pushes that water out. So I was thinking maybe that last point of pressure where the water is would be the part of the kohel gavra. So even if it dripped a little bit, why isn't it called?
Okay, we don't have like a very like set measurement of how long you have that it still counts as kohel gavra from the moment that you turn the tap. So for how long you have like water coming out that it counts as part of your kohel gavra? We don't have that, but. What you're saying, it makes sense. I'm not saying no, but we didn't see it inside, so it's hard to make like estimations like that and give it a full halacha status. Anyhow, we got to Kaf Vav here, and then it says what I said before, that you can literally pick up the barrel and pull from the top of the barrel if you can, but. Usually, if it's a really barrel, so it's too much. Kaf Zayin in Mishnah Berurah. Oilu mitchila neesa. Uadin im neesa nekev bekli avatlo mishem kli. Okay. Every time you have a vessel that originally, when they made a vessel, they made a holder for whatever reason. So it will not cancel the concept of a vessel there, right? Now, what about if you have a vessel that you bought as a complete vessel, and you yourself, after you got it to your house, you made the hole and you put the tap there. That's you fine. Touched it. So it's still fine because it's a way of tikkun. You fixed the vessel to have a tap. You didn't ruin the vessel, right? One of your kids is taking a hammer and like and makes a hole in there, that's something else. That's a way of destroying a vessel, right? But as long as it is a way of fixing it, that it will function better, that it will be like more useful for you, whatever, so that's a way of tikkun. So this doesn't cancel that halachic position of that as a vessel, right? כן, שם ברזה להשתמש דרך שם, חשיב גם כן כאילו נעשה מתחילה לכך. So it doesn't really matter which stage of the vessel history it happened, that it got the tap there. The point is that it was the hole was made for a tap, and not as a destroying the vessel. כיוון שאתה ייחד הברזה, נעשה כלי על ידי זה. whenever he's making that it will be like tikkun, that it will be adapter, so that will be fine. Even by the way, if the hole was done not purposely, let's say he didn't plan to have a hole there, but now after his child is already like made a hole in the barrel, so he said, okay, so I'll put the tap there, right? So the child destroyed the vessel, but he fixed the vessel, so that's fine. Bottom line, he have a vessel. He can use it to wash hands, right? So that's good. Now, okay. Kaf chet. Al yedei lekabel yedei kach. Rotze lomar al yedei abarze shtechuv sham machzik maim shelo yishapchu derech hanekev. So again, when he's talking about the tap, he's talking about some kind of a handle that is stuck inside of the hole, and then you move it up or you pull it out, something like that, and then the water flushes, right? So again, as long as the handle is stuck there, so it prevents the water from coming out. Okay, so later rabbis are saying that if we're talking about a clay pot, yeah, I guess the first thing was wood. Usually the barrels was made out of wood. I think that probably plastic will count as wood for that matter, because both of them have a certain flexibility. But when you're talking about clay, so the clay, it have the stick have to fit exactly to the hole, otherwise it will drip. So as long as it drips, doesn't hold the water, so then it's not really a vessel. Yeah, so you have to get to that position, to that status, that it doesn't leak. So when the handle is stuck there, when the tap is closed, it shouldn't leak. Otherwise, the vessel is not a vessel again, because it cannot hold the water, right?
What's menatefet have?
Dripping.
No.
Okay. The menatef tif tif lo adif mein lo haya shem bar zaklal. If it drips, right, one drip after another, so it means it's like there's no tap there. There's a hole in the bucket. Can't use it. Filo yitor derech hanekev asur, av shemachzik revi'it min hanekev olemata. And then it will be the whole discussion that we had in the beginning, if you can use the vessel that have a hole through the hole, right, and we had the whole discussion there. Shar kelim mutar litol derech nekev imachzik, and the rest of the vessels you can use it through that hole. Imachzik revi'it, as long as it holds the amount of the revi'it mimena olamata, from the hole downwards. Fizze ba'an the pass in this barrel that they had, she'abarza b'shulei akli lemata, so the tap is in the side of the vessel, in the bottom. Imena meudeket, if it is not tight, u'metaftef ha'mayim derech sham, and there is dripping of that through the tap, nitbatla miliyot kli ad she'tekna, so then it is not a vessel anymore, and you can't do netilat edayim for it and from that until you will fix it. Basul litol mena, right? So that's something that is not permissible to use to wash hands. Very good, guys. Now we're moving back to the two vav, yeah, two vav. Lo yiten mayim lechavero bechofnav. You cannot hold water in your hands and flash it on the hands of your friend, that he will do netilat yadayim like that. Doesn't work. Okay? She'en odlim ela min hakli. Why? Because as we said before, you have to have a vessel. You can't wash hands without a vessel. Katav Rambam zal kli shenishbar שבירה המתארתו מידי תומעה אין בלי ממנו לידיים מישהו שבר כלי. And that's what we said before in the beginning of the siman, that a vessel that is broken in a way that this breakdown will purify it if it got impured, so then in the same breath that vessel cannot use for washing hands anymore, right? Why? Because it's a broken vessel, like we said before. Let's see Vav in the Bet Yosef. לא ייתן מים לחברו בחופניו משנה פרק כמה דיידיים. Okay, so we said that there is a tractate in Mishneyot, Taharot, it is called tractate Yadayim. So there we have a clear Mishnah about the halachah we just read here. Right, we have the Rashba on Chulin that says there, כתוב בתוספת בשם רבנו תם, מותר ליטול ידו אחת מן הכלי ולשפוך ממנה לידו אחרת. You can wash one hand from the vessel and then pour from this, that first hand to the other hand. כיוון שתחילת נטילה היה מן הכלי באחת מן הידיו, because the first hand was washed with the vessel, so it's like extension of that wash, of the first washing to the second hand. Okay? Tu lo tzarich, you don't need more than that. Achi mashu matosefta, ktani aval notel, noten, venoten lechavero bechofnav yadam tmeot. But, so what's the difference between what we read before, right? That if you taking the water, you didn't do netilat yadayim, and you're taking the water in your hands, that your hands are impure, and you want to drop it on your on the hands of your friend to purify his hands, but how can you help him to purify himself when you are not pure? Yeah? So you have to use something to purify one hand, then this one hand can purify the other hand, and then you have hands that your hands are pure. But
what if you wash? What if you wash first, then can you use it as to hold for your friend?
Seems according to that the answer will be yes. You can wash first and then use your hands to wash the hands of your friend.
But it sounds, from what we're learning, we need a vessel to purify our hands.
Yes.
And how do you purify another hand through another hand without a vessel? Like, it doesn't...
Okay, let's read. There's a little bit more to read here. Let's read together. It says... So the hands are impure. Because the first thing you didn't wash from a vessel. So according to that, that's the conclusion of the Rashba, that it's possible to wash the hands and then you can use your hands to wash the hands of your friend. Okay? That's the understanding of the Rashba. The Rashba on Chulin. Right now, Aval beTorat Abayit. Torat Abayit is another book of the Rashba, that is more like Halacha LeMaaseh according to the Rashba. Katav ze leshono amru mishmo shel Rabbeinu Tam. Rabbeinu Tam says sheim natal biyado achat min hakli. If he is washing one hand from the vessel, menatan al yado hashniya, and then he gives over on the second hand. Mutar, the reason it is permitted, לפי שכיוון שבא לידו אחד מן הכלי, כוח הכלי קריבה. After the you washed one hand with the vessel, so the power of the vessel is called upon this hand. ולא דומה לנותן מחופניו של חברו, שלא מכוח כלי בא ליד זה כלל. And it is not like the other case that you're taking the water in your hands and dropping it on your friend, and there it didn't come from a vessel at all. Okay, so it didn't really say it clearly, but from the way that it is written here, what I understand is that he's talking about the case that you're taking from a vessel, you pour it on your hand and you catch some of the water from the vessel and then you drop it on the other hand.
Okay, that's why it transfers.
So the same water that were like coming from the vessel are coming to the next hand also.
And that's the way of the...
And it's not like a case that you're taking water in your hand and you drop it on your friend and then you expect that he will get pure by that.
And it's also not like the case where you do netirat yadayim on one hand and then with that hand you do the other hand.
Right.
That's all.
And why not if that hand's also impure?
So that's a different understanding. That's what we read in the Rashba before, but here it's saying a little bit differently. אבל הרמב״ם כתב נוטל ידו אחת וצק בזו על זו וחוזר וצק בראשונה על השנייה. Okay, the Rambam in Masechet Brachot, he says that he is washing one hand and then he's using one hand to purify the other hand, and then he can go back and like the first hand on the second hand. עד כאן. כלומר שצריך נטילה זו על זו נטילה על זו ועל זו. נראים דבר עד כאן לשנו. So according to that, according to the Rambam, you have to wash both hands. That's obvious, but it doesn't clarify if he's using the vessel on both hands. It seems that no.
It seems like he uses the vessel on one hand and then one hand.
Right, that's the words of the Rashba, but then he says, Tzarich Nitila al zu ve'al zu. You need to wash this hand and that hand.
Okay.
So it's not 100% clear. Anyhow, we'll see later. אמרתי כי פרק אלו דברים למדנו התוספת הזו שנותן מידו אחת על חברתה אסור. So the Mordechi learned from the same source that take in your hand and draw and wash the other hand is forbidden. וזה לשון שיבולי הלקט. שיבולי הלקט is also one of the main sources of הלכה. מצאתי בשם רבנו תם, according to רבנו תם, שמותר ליטול מים מן הכלי בידו אחת. You can wash from a vessel one hand, נותן על השנייה, and to wash from that first and the second hand. הרמב"ם תוסף את הפרק ב', and he brings a proof from the תוספתא that we spoke about. פרק ב' בעל התרומה כתב שצריך שישפוך המים על ידו אחת. Again, also בעל התרומה says the same thing. ולא תיגע בינתיים היד בחברתה. And to make sure that the first hand doesn't touch the second hand before the second hand gets pure. Okay? That's an important point that we'll discuss further on. Also, when you have one person is washing the hands of someone else, so to be careful not to touch the hands of the other guy before they're getting pure, because then the first person will have to re-wash his hands again. We'll discuss about it in length afterwards. Anyhow, ותנן, and he brings the Mishnah in מסכת ידיים, נטל ידו אחד ושפשפה בחברתה תמאה. If he's washing one hand and then he's rubbing it with the other hand that was not washed, so the first hand is impure again. Yeah? So whenever you wash hands, you have to be careful when the hands are wet not to touch anything that is not pure. Yeah? Generally.
Is that the reason why they say not wipe on your clothes?
No, that's something else.
So you shouldn't carry food or anything until you dry?
Carry food? What do you mean?
Say you have a plate or you're going, like you're washing and you have...
You didn't have a towel to dry your hands.
Exactly.
Your hands are wet and you want to carry your plate to your place. The plate is not a problem, but to touch another person that he didn't wash yet,
okay,
specifically in his hands, that will be a problem.
There's a concept that if you go into the bathroom, you get naturally tuma, just by going into the restroom.
Yeah.
So if you have a kli inside, if you have to wash your hands inside the restroom, it says don't dry your hands inside, wait until you leave the restroom to dry your hands. Why?
Yeah, that's a different thing. That's a different thing, because there we don't want to finish the process of washing of the hands, that you won't have to wash your hands again.
Mm-hmm.
So the end of the washing of the hands is the drying of the hands. So we're counting on that to say that until you didn't dry your hands, so your hands didn't got impure from the fact that you've been in the bathroom. But it's a little stretch. But you know, if that's all what you can do, so that's all what you can do.
And after you dry your hands, you also shouldn't touch anyone.
After you dry your hands, you're fine. The point that the hands are wet. So that's a sensitive in between status.
So if they're dry, even if touching somebody's hand in the morning hasn't dried, it's no problem. Hasn't washed.
That's another halacha of touching someone that he didn't wash the hands in the morning. That the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch says that you have to wash your hands after that.
Okay.
I see that most of the people are not like precise about it, but it doesn't mean that it's not the right thing to do. The right thing to do would be to wash hands afterwards, but practically it's a...
How do you know? Do you have to assume that...
You don't know, that's my point, that most of the people are not precise about it. If you like walk in the street and you see your friend, you shake his hand. You don't know if he washed his hands in the morning, if he's not religious, so probably he didn't. So you go right away and you wash your hands. I didn't see people do that.
Mm.
But preferably, yes, the answer would have been yes. And there is people that are very, like, they are trying not to touch people, generally. I don't know if you know people like that, but there is a few people that I know that they are trying not to shake hands and not to touch people, generally. So that could be one of the reasons.
The tumah is transferred even if you touch any other part of his body, like if you touch his head or his ear or something. No, it lies directly on the finger.
there is extra sensitivity about the hands. The hands are more affected
apparently
by the impurity. Yeah. Anyhow, that will be a different class.
A different halacha class.
Yeah. This is in the beginning of Shabbat, I have not discussed. Anyhow. Katab. I already read that. Rega. Yeah. תומת הדשן כתב בסימן ריש נון ט' בשם תוספות מסכת זוטה רבנו תם וזה לשונו. אוקיי, so brings the תומת הדשן brings רבנו תם that says על מנהג העולם שזורקים מן הכלי על ידו האחת. So it seems that in their time there was a really custom like that. That's what people did, that they like throwing with the from the vessel on one hand וחוזר ומשפשפה בחברתה, and is and then he's rubbing this first hand on the other hand. Shapir dami is doing good. Why? Because first he washed from the vessel. Tanya mitosefta de adam, aber noten mayim lechaveru bechov nav. Tanya natal dvar achad v'shivshev bechavatat me'a. So what is the reason that we say in the tosefta, if you are washing, if you're rubbing your hands together after you washed one hand and you didn't wash the other hand, so the first hand that you did wash is impure. What's the reason we say that? That says Rabbeinu Tam, that's talking about a special case that your whole intention was only to wash one hand. And for that reason, if you rubbed it with the other hand, then it became to be impure. Okay? So that seems a little bit different than what we said before. But then it says, So the Biet Yosef is commenting, I think it's the Biet Yosef, maybe it's the Tumat Deshen. But anyhow, it says that it's a stretch to say what they say. This split between those two cases is a little stretch. If they are split, is if you have your original intention to wash one hand or two hands. Ben lismochalav, so you cannot rely on that because it's something that we didn't hear about a split like that. L'inyan shifshuf yad b'chavrata, the akol ha-gonim kotvu b'endia le'isu, all of the geonim says it is forbidden, and we follow them, so don't try it at home, as they say. What?
Don't wash one hand with the other.
Don't. If you do wash one hand with the vessel, so don't rub it with the other hand and expect that the first hand will stay pure. Bedek habayit. Veli nireh de'im lo shifshef yad b'chaverta, ela shafach miyado achad l'acheret, lo alta lo netila. Says, seems to me that even if you didn't rub your hands together, rather, you, after washing your first hand with the vessel, you use that first hand to take water and wash with those water the other hand. He says, it's not called washing hands. So now you have to dry your second hand and wash it properly. Because the water that was in the first hand was impure. Ve'im itel et derabenutam kshehayta yado harishona tehora. And if you want to say like Rabenutam that the first hand is pure, kegon shenadla v'nigva, meaning that you washed it and dried it. Okay, I think that's the key word here, that you washed it and dried it. In the first case, he's talking about the case that you washed it and you didn't dry it. So then he's counting that the water that are left on the first hand getting the impurity. And then when you're taking more water on that first hand, so it gets also impure. That's the opinion of the Bedek Abayit here. Another possibility, and that's what we're trying to do, to wash the whole hand in Revi'it at once. and then it doesn't get the impurity, the water. Like it will explain further on. חילוק שכתב שם בשם התוספות זל אין לו שחר ואינו לו מתוספות ואלא ואינו מן התוספות אלא שום תלמיד טועה כתבו. He says what he said in the name of תוספות, the תרומת הדשן, he says it's not related to תוספות. It's a some kind of a mistaken student that wrote a mistake. Okay.
So wait, what is he saying is a mistake exactly?
That there is a possibility to wash one hand with a vessel and then rub the two hands together.
Oh, okay.
He says that's not right. A possibility. No one says it. Okay. Continuing in the Bet Yosef, Katav Rambam, Perek Vav, Malachot Brachot. Kli shenishbar shverato metarto midei tuma. So he said that in the name of the Rambam, who brings it, that if you have a vessel that got broken in a way that it will get pure if it was impure, so it means this breakdown is a real breakdown that you cannot use it to wash hands anymore. And it seems that the Rambam is speaking about, even though that vessel can contain an amount of revi'it, let's say 50 liters according to my calculation from there downwards, שאם לא כן, מהירי הנשבע, אפילו לא נשבע נמי, because if it would not receive the amount of revi'it, so without breakdown, just you can't wash with a vessel that cannot contain the amount of revi'it. משמע נמי אפילו ליטול ממנו דרך הנקב לא מעני. And according to those words, it seems that you cannot wash even through the hole that was done through the broken, through the breakdown. כל מקום שבר כלי הוא, ואין, כל שאין שם כלי, עליו אין עוד לי ממנו לידיים. So because basically the reason is because it's not count as a vessel, and something that is not a vessel you cannot use to wash hands. לפי זה כלי חרס שניקב בכונס משקה. So according to that, the clay vessel that was broke down in a way that it will receive liquids will come in to that vessel. כיוון שהוא מתאר מתומתו בכך, and also it's getting pure if it got impure.
So it would hold vessel, it would hold liquids?
It will okay. Not hold liquids.
No.
כדנן פרק ג' דקלים שיעור כלי חרס לתאר עשוי לאוכלין שיעורו באוכלין למשקין שיעורו במשקין. Okay, so again, the הלכה of vessels, when does the breakdown make the vessel to be pure? So it depends what is the function of that vessel. If it's a vessel that it's supposed to hold liquids, so when it cannot hold liquids, so then it's not a vessel anymore and it's getting pure. If it's a vessel that's supposed to hold foods, so then when it cannot hold the food that it's designated for, then it's not a vessel anymore and it's getting pure. Right? בסוף פרק המצניע אמרינן זה שיעור המשקין היינו בכונס משקה. And again, what is the measurement, the size of the hole that it will stop being called a liquid vessel? When it is kones mashkeh, when the liquids can come into that vessel. If can pasul hu litol meno, and then it becomes to be not good to wash from, filu derech hanekev, even through the hole. Kedat smag, according to the smag, v'zeh hefech im ma shekatav rabbeinu, this is the opposite of what the tool said, the kol kli shenikav, every vessel that got hole, bekones mashkeh, through with the kones mashkeh, when the liquids come in, אפילו שנפסל מליטול דרך פיו, even though it is not good to wash through the edges of the vessel on top, כל מקום כאשר הוא ליטול דרך הנקב, but you can still wash from the hole down. אם כן, יש לדמוע, איך כתב רבנו למעלה אותו דין סתם. So it's a wonder on the Rambam, on the tour that brings the Rambam, why he says it like that, the way it does. אחר כך כתב כאן דברי הרמב״ם סתם, right, so he made like a contradiction. One time he writes that you can use from the, you can wash from the hole, And then he brings the words of the Rambam that according to the Rambam you cannot wash through the hole. So the tool is contradicting himself. First he brings the halacha from the Rosh that says yes, then he brings the halacha from the Rambam that says no. So what is the halacha according to the two? Okay? He says, נראה ששני דינים אלו אינם סותרים זה את זה. So he says that we have to say that according to the two, there's no contradiction here. The question is, what's the logic? Why it's not a contradiction? מוצאתי לבעל תרומת הדשן שנסתפק בדברי הרמב״ם אם הם דווקא בניקב וכונס משקה בשולב. Okay, so he brings the opinion of תרומת הדשן that he have a doubt how to understand the Rambam. When the Rambam says those words that we read, does it mean we're talking about the hole in the side of the vessel specifically? כונס משקה שאינו מחזיק רביעית למטה מן הנקב, and then you can say that it doesn't hold the amount of the water of רביעית from the hole downward. אם מחזיק משקה מן הנקב ולמטה כשר, but if it does hold the 50 milliliters, so then it will be kosher. Or אפילו בגלל גבנה נאם פסיל. Or maybe that even in that way that it's hold the 50 milliliters, it still will be kosher. Okay, that's the two sides of the doubt of Tumat Deshen, how to understand the Rambam. Yeah? ונראה דמאי דמספקא לבעל תרומת הדשן. Now comes about Yosef and explains what was exactly the doubt of the תרומת הדשן. פשיטא לרבנו דלדעת הרמב״ם. So is from that doubt of תרומת הדשן on the רמב״ם. So from that the בית יוסף is concluding how to understand the opinion of the two on the רמב״ם. Okay? So he's saying that רבנו, meaning the two, holds that the opinion of the Rambam, Nami no nifsar b'nika b'kones mashke, Elam ken, no machzik revit, minane kerim lamata. That the two holds that the Rambam holds, that the vessel will still call the vessel the wash hands, even though there's a holder, as long as you have the capacity of holding the 50 milliliters, the revit, from the hole downwards. אבל אם מחזיק רביעית מן הנקב ולמטה, אלא אם כן, אינו מחזיק. כן. אבל אם מחזיק רביעית מן הנקב ולמטה, כאשר, as long as it holds the amount of רביעית, from the whole downwards, it will be kosher. משום מה, כתב כלי שנשבע ולא כתב כלי שניקב. That's why the Rambam says, כלי שנשבע, a vessel that broke down. And it doesn't say, כלי שניקב, a vessel that got a hole. דקייבן דאינו מחזיק רביעית מן הנקב ולמטה הרי הוא כאילו נשבע. So if the hole makes it that it will not hold the 50 milliliters from the hole downwards, then it means as if it's got broken. תם זהו עולה מתומתו לידי כך. So that will be the reason that it getting pure from the impurity, and also it's the same reason that it cannot be used for washing hands. כן מצאתי לרשב"א שכתב בתורת הבית, and also the רשב"א in תורת הבית wrote something similar זה לשונו. Those are the words of the רשב"א. כלי שניקב נקב גדול עד שהוא מכניס משקים. A vessel that got a big hole that is able to bring in liquids. כשאדם מושיבו על המים, if you push it into the water, הרי זה פסול. So then that vessel is not good. מה דברים אומרים? What is that talking about? בזמן שניקב בשולי הכלי. When it got the hole in the side of the vessel. עד שאינו מקבל רביעית. To the point that he cannot hold the amount of the רביעית מן הנקב למטה from the hole downwards. אבל אם מקבל רביעית מן הנקב למטה, but if it does hold the 50 milliliters from the hole downwards, קשה, it will be kosher. מה דברים אומרים? What case we're talking about here? בכלי שאין שבירה זו מעלה אותו מתומתו. A vessel that the breakdown does not bring it up from the impurity. אבל כל כלי שניקב או נשבר. But any vessel that got punctured or hole, שבר מעלה אותו מידי תומתו. a way of breaking down that will bring him at, bring it up from the impurity, pasul. That will be no good.
Brings it out of the impurity, or into, or it makes it a process susceptible to impurity.
From the question, I see that you missed probably this class. What did I explain it? So I'll say it again. We have a concept that vessels, when something is called a vessel, usually depends on the material, it can get impurity.
Mm.
So a vessel that got impurity, and then it got broken or torn or something, that it's not a vessel anymore, so then it's pure because it's not a vessel. When it's a vessel, it can it receives the impurity. If it's not a vessel, it doesn't receive the impurity.
Got it.
So, אבל כל כלי שנקרא שנשבר שבר המעלה אותו מדי תומתו פסול לפי שאין כלי זה אלא שבר כלי. So when we say that the breakdown is making the vessel that it will not be pure, it will be pure if it got impure, because it's a broken vessel. So if it's a broken vessel, you also you cannot use it to wash hands. ונראה אדם אשכח את הכלי העולה מתומתו בנקב פחות מכונס משקה כגון שהוא גיסטרה. So what will be the example for a vessel that got pure by the hole, but the hole is so small that it is not kones mashke? Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So he says, kigon shu gistra. What is gistra? So gistra is a vessel that is not good enough to use as a vessel for itself, but it can be a support to another vessel. Yeah? So I gave an example that many times you see that, like in gardens, that they have like a pottery that got broken, and then they use the old broken pottery as a base, and they put a new pottery inside of it. So that broken pottery is called gistra. It's a vessel that got broken, but the piece that is broken is big enough that it will be under a good vessel.
You said the broken vessel is called gistra?
Yeah. So when you have this gistra, and we have a gemara in Masechet Shabbat speaks about it, שהוא עולה מתומתו בניקב כמוציא משקה, that it will come up from the impurity when it gets a hole in the size of מוציא משקה, when it brings out liquids. כן כתב הרמב"ם פרק י"ט מלאכות כלים, and also the Rambam says, speaks about it in הלכות כלים, והרמב"ם שם נראה שהוא סובר כדעת הרשב"א, and it seems that the Rambam agrees with the Rashba about the הלכות בסתם כלים, אומרים להם בהו דניקה וכונס משקה. So there in the other vessels we say when there is a hole that is כונס משקה, then liquids can come in, מעלה אותם מטומתן, it will bring them up from their status of impurity, דווקא כשאין מחזיקין רביעית מן הנקב, only when it does not hold the amount of רביעית from the hole downwards. אבל אם היו מחזיקים רביעית, but if it does hold the amount of רביעית, עדיין שם כלי עליהם, it's still called a vessel, שאפילו שבר כלי, and even a broken vessel, אם הוא מחזיק רביעית, if it holds the רביעית, כתב שהוא מתמה, it will be impure. So meaning it is called a vessel because it can become to be impure, right? Kedemash perek pet perek gimel de kelim, and we brings proof from that from the Mishnah of Masechet Kelim. Aval bishgadav be'alachot brachot, even though it says in the alachot brachot she'en otlin midfanot hakelim, that you don't wash from the sides of the vessels, lo bishulei amachatz ve'lo becharsid, not from the there's okay, so talking about all kinds of vessels that they had in their time that we don't have today, but the point of the matter is lo bemagufat achavit, so all kinds of different vessels that it's not their function to hold liquids. Yeah, something that is like a piece of another vessel. So we gave the example before, last week we spoke about the cover of the barrel, that it can contain liquids, but it is not made to contain liquids. It's made to be a cover of another vessel, or a head, right? So something like that it's not the usage of it. So lechatchila we don't use it, right? Lam mishum shever kli pasal ze lo elam pnei she'inam mekablim revit. So basically, the whole reason that they don't have enough space to revi'it shalom sumachin when they are without leaning on something. And this is something similar to what we spoke about the lid of the barrel, as I said before. Nagad ba'deu, that we spoke about afal pi she'katav im tiken ha'magufah lentila, and it says that if you fix the cover of the barrel, that it will be good for washing hands, not leaving like that, then you can wash hands from it. Right? What is the tikkun? Remember? Two conditions.
To hold the
revit. One to hold the revit and
intention to make it a clean.
That's when you're doing the tikkun, so you have the intention to do the tikkun. But what is the other point? That it will stand without leaning on something, right? That it will stand for itself, right? If it have to lean on something, otherwise it will splash. So then it's not good.
It has to hold the revit with standing by itself.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
We talked about the clean of the cut.
And then, so basically, all of those different vessels, if you do some kind of a tikkun for that vessel, that it will hold the revit and will stand for itself, then it's good. And is speaking like widely about, like generally about all those different things. And we have the clear example for that about the lid of the barrel, that it says there in Per Kol HaBasar, in Chulin, right, we read it, Kuf Zayin, right? Kuf Zayin. Then Tikna, not Limin Aladayim, if you do the Tikkun there, so you can wash hands from there. Rav Achad Amineu Nekad Vuadin Le'inach. So he took one example about the lid of the barrel, but really, he's talking about all of the different kinds of vessels, as long as it will hold the Revit and it will stand by itself, it can be used to wash hands. Okay. Inami, another possibility, le'avut nakat megufa, that when he's speaking about the lid of the barrel, he's saying that to extend the concept, that even that, aval bi she'en chalala asu lekabala, me'ani batikun, that even though the space within the lid of the barrel was not supposed to receive liquids, still, the tikkun can help it. Of course, you can let for another kelim with domem, and how much more so if you're talking about the side, the vessels, and other things that are similar. Can go through Tosfot Per Kol HaBasar, and also Tosfot in Per Kol HaBasar said it, Night Kuf Zayin, Bura Mechil Megofa. Gabel Megofa Tachavit, Asui Lekabla, so about the lid of the barrel, it says, Mehani Batikun, כל שכן לפנות את הכלים, no. שתקנה, מגופת החבית שתקנה פסולה. Again, the lid of the barrel, it says it's פסול, לפנות הכלים מפני שאין יושבים שלא מסומכים. Because it doesn't stand for itself, without leaning on something. משמע שאם היו מחזיקים רביעית שלא מסומכים קשרים, and you understand that from there, that if it was holding the רביעית without leaning on anything, it would have been kosher. So, I just want to make sure that we understand what we're speaking about. So let's say this is a barrel, yeah? So you have an opening on the top, and then it got like cracked in the middle. So you have half a barrel, yeah? You have this half, this half. So then you take it and you lie down, yeah? So you have a half a barrel, but it's not standing because it's rounded, so it's not standing. If you fill it with water, so probably it will splash, because it cannot hold. That it will hold, you have to stack like stones in the sides that will stabilize it, otherwise, right, it won't hold. So that's something that you cannot use to wash hands, right? So what will be the tikkun for something like that? If you put like a set, not just to stack a stone there, to connect like a legs in the sides of that half a barrel, that it will stabilize it, so it becomes to be part of the vessel, yeah? So you connect with it, so that will be tikkun that will make it that it will be fitting for washing hands then.
Let's say you took those two stones and you glued them on the counter, and that's where that barrel, let's say it was a small barrel that you put and used in the other time, then you would be able to, because that's it's designated area to stand like that?
Yes, but it's not enough to designate the area. You need to designate that vessel.
So you designate that vessel to be there.
Right.
Okay.
Right. Okay. Now going back to the opinion of the Rosh Beresh Yadayim in the beginning of the Masechet Yadayim, the size of the vessels, like my example of the half of a barrel, or shulei machatz, I'm not sure what is shulei machatz, it's edges of some kind of a broken vessel, shivrei kelim ninu. So all of that is considered to be broken vessels. צריך לומר, דהיינו, לומר שאינם מקבלים רביעית. That's to say that they cannot hold the amount of רביעית. אבל אם מקבלים רביעית, but if they do hold רביעית, אף על פי שברי כלים, אם נוטלים מהם לידיים, even though it is broken vessels, you can wash hands from that. Okay? So you see that the Rosh is much more lenient about it. Right? And that's also the reason that we saw that in the Tur, in the beginning of the Siman, because the Rosh is the son of the Rosh, so he took his father's opinions, right? Dat Rabbeinu Shimshon, another Rishon that says the same thing. Katab Perikam and Maser Dedaim, the Ita Betosefta, Chamat veKipsha, right? So he says there about Chemet. You remember Chemet? How did we translate Chemet? The leather flask. Fine. So the leather flask. Even though it is like when it's empty, so it doesn't hold anything, but you can wash hands from there. And he explained himself, as long as they're holding the amount of revit, otherwise it won't be good. Sefta kata shekatav od sham tani shulei klei etz v'klei etzem. So the edges, I'm not sure exactly what does it mean when it says edges of vessels. I'm not sure, but maybe if let's say that was a big vessel, big like bowl, and then like there's some kind of a like a to make it like more beautiful, so it has but like
to guide the water. Edges,
like in the sides of the vessel has like edges. So if I want to fill that edges around with water and then to wash the hands from that, not from the vessel itself. So it's not good. Why? Because those edges doesn't count as a vessel. It's just for beauty, just like adornment for the main vessel. Yeah.
So that
was one possibility because it doesn't hold revit. But we're saying even if it does hold a reed, it's not made for that. So if it's not made for that, so even if it does hold, so it's not a vessel.
I have a question.
Unless you designate it. What?
If you have a barrel, like say like a square barrel, like a box type thing, which if it does break in half, it would be able to stand on its own. You wouldn't be able to use it for a kli because you didn't fix it.
That will be another machloket. If a broken vessel is a vessel, that will be the opinion of the Rosh and the Tur, and Biet Yosef brings that opinion, or according to the Mishna Berurah, we go stringency and we say because it's broken vessel, so it's not a vessel, so you have to redesignate it that it will be used in this way as a half a box. And then you give it the name of vessel and then you can use it to wash hands.
In this case, you say that because of these are decorations, it wouldn't work. Even if you poured through this, the bottom parts of the decoration, supposed. No? That's like
No. At. You're talking about something else. You're talking about decorations here on the edge itself.
Okay.
I'm saying, except, let's say the edge is fine.
Okay.
But around the edge, you have some kind of a leaf kind of sometimes
the water would have to go on top, would go on top of it regardless of
so if that have like some kind of a rounded shape that that can contain water, you cannot use it to wash hands from there because it's not made as a vessel, it's just made as a decoration. Anyhow, so he says it's not a vessel, right? שאינם מקבלים רביעית, אלא מקבלים רביעית אף בשברי כלים מהם, נוטלים מהם לידיים. So, okay, so we have that. כן, הרדעת רבנו שמשון. כן. כלי עץ, כלי עצם, כלי זכוכית, אין נוטלים מהם לידיים. כאן כיסן, שפן, והסען כלים. So basically, he did תיקון for them, that it will be a vessel. נוטלים להם לידיים, then you can use it for wash hands. ואם יש להם קבלת רביעית, if they have the capacity to receive רביעית of water, צריך לומר, פסולה, the פסולה מהני נמי, מפני שאין יושבים שלא מסומכים. Another reason to say it is פסול, because they are, when you place them, you have to lean them on something that they will be able to stand. ונסיים ושפן, אנו שתיקן, מקום מושבן. When it says there's words of כנכיסן ושפן, so it means that he reinforced the place where it stands, the foundation, כדי שישבו שלא מסומכין, that they will sit down without leaning on anything. מעלק תניא עשן כלים, פירושו בכך עשן כלים. And when it says that he made them vessels, meaning by that תיקון, he made them to be vessels. Yeah? Okay. Let's read the Mishna Berurah. First Shulchan Aruch, Vav. Lo yiten mayim lechavero bechofnam. You don't pour water with your hands on your hand, on the hands of your friend. She'enotlim ela min hakli, because we have to wash hands from a vessel. That will be the same law if you wash one hand from the vessel and you wash that first hand to wash the other hand, it's nothing, it's not washing hands. But according to Rabbeinu Tam, that second possibility is permitted. Why? Because the first washing was from a vessel, but that's talking about only in the case that the first hand really got pure, meaning, for example, that you washed the first hand all together at once in the minimum amount of revid. Says the Rama that the Rabbeinu Tam opinion is the minag of Ashkenaz. אבל הסברה הראשונה היא עיקר. But really the first view of the מחבר is the main הלכה, לכן יש להחיל מיר לכתחילה. So לכתחילה we have to be stringent like the שולחן ערוך, but if somebody is doing it like רבנו תם and he knows what he's doing to do it in the right way, so it will be permitted בדיעבד, because there is a מנהג like that, there is a custom like that.
Question, does your hand become pure with one revius, or is it after three? One?
Very good question, Ilan. So basically the first level of purity is coming with the first washing of revit. Yes. And there is people that they say that that's all what you need. You don't need more than that. I was by one rabbi once that he had like a whole big, you know, like thing of Netilat Yadayim, and he washed like one hand, all the water, like one, like from all the sides, one washing, and then another vessel all full on the second hand, one time, that's it. That's the way he did it. Wow. And he's a big rabbi, Rosh Yeshiva in Zichron Yaakov. He's a like serious person. So there is opinion like that. There is people that are holding like that and they're doing that. Okay? According to the Kabbalah, according to the Rizal, that's my custom, is to do like three hands, like three times on each hand anyhow. Doesn't matter which washing of the hands. If it's in the morning, if it's after the bathroom, if it's for the bread, can be different ways, but always there's like three times on each hand. But yeah, there is other opinions. The Vilna Gaon, I think he says four times. Okay. So there is those that are following the Vilna Gaon and they're doing four times on every hand. So anyhow, from what we're learning here, the like the simple pshat of Shulchan Aruch, one time you wash the hand properly, it's fine. It's pure. Good. So now we are in the Mishna Berurah, Sif Katan Kaf Tet. Bechofnav, afilu ayu yadav teorot. Okay? Meaning...
And what does that word mean?
Vav, after the Vav, Kaf Tet.
Yeah, no, no, what does the word mean? Bechofnav?
Chofnav is your hands.
Palms. Oh,
okay. The palms, yeah. So even if your hands are pure, still you cannot use your hands to wash your the hands of your friend. Shafach imena, you drop from the your the first hand to the second hand. I know, achar shekvar nigmar netila miyado achat. After you finished the washing of the first hand, shafach ma'amayim menish'ar toch pisat yado, then you're dropping the water that are left on your palm on the second hand. Right? Alayla shniya. And that's the reason the Shulchan Aruch says this is nothing. It's not called washing hands. Why? The lo ba netila makli, because this second wash, the washing of the second hand is not coming from a vessel. And if you holding the hands one after one under the other, echad alayad aliyona, and there's a person that is pouring on the upper hand. And then from that first hand it pulls down to the second hand. So then the second hand is pure by that. And that is one washing. Okay? So let's say I'm holding my two hands like that for some reason, and I have someone that is pouring from above from a vessel, and then that second hand is receiving the water that dropped on the first hand, but it goes all the way from the vessel also to the second hand. So the second hand is also pure. But if I washed the first hand, and then I'm holding the water that is left, and then I pour it on the second hand, this is not good, because the water that came to the second hand is coming from the hand, not from the vessel. Mm. Yeah? That's the difference.
But the Rama was saying that it was okay.
Let's wait with it. We'll get to the Rama soon. Mishnah Berurah Lamed Aleph. V'u she'aita v'ra lekaman siman kuf samach bet. The maim arishonim shofcham al yado l'shem netila. So further on in siman kuf samach bet, we will see that the first water that was poured on the first hand for the purpose of washing hands, em atzmam nitme'u benegiatan biyadav. Themselves, those water became to be impure when they touches his hands. That's the reason if he's pouring from the first hand to the second hand, it doesn't purify the second hand, because the water themselves are impure. That's why he says, not, it's talking only about the case the first hand is pure. Then the water that is dropping on the first hand are not getting impure, and then it has the capacity of purifying the other hand. Yeah? Sima lamed bet, siman katan lamed bet, teora kadvu achronim, darko panim lo etir Rabbeinu Tam. So the later rabbis explained the opinion of Rabbeinu Tam, what exactly was the special permission that he made. Ela rak lishpoch miyado zo lechaverta, aval lo lishefshef veliga. To pour from the first hand on the second hand without touching the first hand in the second hand. The in is a shevi gaba, because if you will touch the second hand, even though it's pure, nitmad benigiyat chaverta, it will become impure when it's the other hand is touching it. Meaning, let's say the first hand is pure. So the water that came to the first hand is not getting impure because the hand is pure. So the water are pure in the hand, then you can use that water to purify the second hand, right? But if when you drop it like this and you're touching the second hand, yeah? So then you made this hand to be impure from this hand, because this hand didn't purify yet. So you impuring the first hand from the second hand. So then you have both hands that are not pure. Right? So, yeah? Clear? Again, what Rabbeinu Tam said, it is allowed. If the first hand is pure, and you're taking water in that first hand and dropping on the second hand without touching, and those waters somehow cover the second hand, then you're good. Okay? My problem is that with that is that the amount of water that you can hold in your hand is not enough to cover the second hand. So it doesn't really make sense to me. How can it be possible? But if somebody can do that somehow, gesundheit. Fine.
Big hands.
What?
Big hands.
Yeah, but if the hands are big, so both of the hands are big, right?
Oh, yeah.
If you have like one hand that is huge and it holds the amount of water that will cover the second hand, the second hand is small, so okay, you know, poor guy that he has such hands, what can I say? Yeah, I don't know how it's possible. Anyhow, Bezerat Hashem. Lamed Gimel Mishna Berurah Revit Bevat Achat Kigon Beze Av Sheedat Me'ah Nitera B'Shficha Achat. Right? So again, if you're pouring a whole Revit on the first hand at once, so then the water doesn't become to be impure, the hand becomes pure and the water stays pure. וגם המים עצמם לא נטמאו, דרביעית בבת אחת עשויה כמקווה המטהרת. When you have the רביעית water that is dropped at once, so it has a certain quality like mikveh, that like mikveh, the impure person is coming into the mikveh, the water of the mikveh does not become to be impure. It has the quality of purity that it stays pure, right? So also those water that the 50 milliliters according to my calculation that you're dropping at one time, so it stays pure even though it touches the hand that is impure. Okay? גם הם תיאורים, כדלקמן סימן קוף סמך ב', we'll read about it later on. אני יכול לשפוך ממים אלו גופם שנתקבצו תוך פיסת ידו השנייה, and then you can use that same water to drop it on the second hand. מי הוא? זה דווקא רעים שפך רביעית על ידו כראוי. That's again when you're pouring the amount of the revit on the hand properly. דהיינו כדינת הילה על כל יד מפנינו וחוץ. Right, that's what I just said before. That to cover the hand from inside and outside. דהילו שפך כולה רק תוך פיסת ידו. If you're pouring from one hand to the second hand and you hold it in the second hand now, so it's only in the inner aspect of the hand. You don't have it covering the outside of the hand, right? And the נטילה כראוי, this is not the way to wash hands. וידו הראשונה עצמה טמאה, וגם המים נטמאו בה. And then it might be that you will touch both hands together to rub it, and then both of the hands will become to be impure, because the second hand didn't become to be pure, right? למד דלת, עיקר, כן דעת שערי הפוסקים. So the most of the rabbis are not agreeing with Rabbeinu Tam about it. לכתחילה ורשאל החמיר אף בדיעבד. Okay? The רשאל, Rabbeinu Shlomo, says that even בדיעבד it's not good to wash like this. גם לדעת הרמה או דווקא בשעת הדחק. And even if you want to rely on the רמה, it's only in a place of a real need. אבל בנזמנו למים איתו לשנית בלי ברכה. But if afterwards you're getting more water to wash hands properly, so you should wash again without saying bracha. Okay, we'll hold it here. Baruch Adonai l'olam. Amen v'amen.